Smile makers training. Okay, once again, welcome everyone. So we have Dr. Sharda, Brindavan Yoga, and me from Smile Makers Training. And we have Krish, our able supporter. Where is Krish?
Today is not Krish, it's Aurya.
Aurya, is it? Okay. Hi. So our topic for today is very interesting. It is on diabetes. So do you know one of the reasons why people get diabetes is because there is a lack of sweetness in their lives? And, you know, I want to start with a small story, which is actually a true story. You know, when the Iranians came from their ship to India, they landed in a place in Gujarat. And the local king over there, they went to and asked him permission, can they set up their base over there? And the king said, you know what, we're already full. There are so many, what can you do when there is a, it's like a pot full of milk. What can you do? You know, when there's so much of milk, there is no place for anything else. And, you know, this man, he said, get me a pot of milk. And what he did is that, he added a little sugar to that. And the milk was the same, but what was missing was the sweetness. And he said, you know what? We are going to bring sweetness to this community. So I want you to spend some time in your life. Your life is full. You're doing so many things. You brought this, you got that, you worked hard to reach where you are today. And you feel there's nothing more you can add to your life because you've been there, done this, done that, seen that, heard that. But you need to ask yourself, how can I bring more sweetness into my life? And one of the tips for bringing sweetness into your life is by using sweet energy words. You know, words play a very, very important part in the energy that you create around you. And most of the time, we are very, very free in using bitter words. You know, the situation around is like this, COVID is like this, pandemic is like that, people are like this. And you catch yourself every time you start taking out bitter words from your mouth. You know, and the world doesn't need that. What the world needs is a little more of sweetness. So, you know, so for example, if you're sitting on the table and you're eating food and one there's salt less in one item, and you say, oh God, look at this, no salt, what is this? No soup. Instead of that, you can just pick up the salt and add salt instead of, you know, grumbling. And, you know, we are very easy with our bitter words, but we are very selfish and very conscious, as they say. You know, miserly when it comes to giving sweet words. So one small thing for today is be aware of what is the nature of words that come out from your mouth. Okay? And as far as possible, use sweet words which adds to the sweetness of the energy around you, which adds to the sweetness in your life. Okay? So the more sweetness you bring in your life, less chance is there for you to get diabetes, you know? So think about it, yeah? So that's it for now regarding with sweet words in your life, and over to Dr. Sharda to take today's session forward. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to update people as well. Good evening, everybody. It was a nice session about how we have to bring sweetness into our life, because with so much stress around, we are literally forgetting how to make our life more sweeter. It's more about bitterness around. So every person tries in their own way to make it sweet. I think this world will be a better place to live. So let me start with diabetes. Diabetes is very, very common in India, and I guess everybody knows what diabetes is. So basically, diabetes is where the blood sugar levels are more than what it should be. So there is a state called pre-diabetes and diabetes. So a pre-diabetic state is where when you check your blood sugar, you will be sitting at the fence. So if you check your blood sugar levels during your fasting, you will be 100 or more, 100 milligrams per deciliter. So you will be more than that. So that is a place where you are going to be diabetic pretty soon. That is if you don't take care of yourself. It's a warning sign that you are pretty much going to be diabetic if you continue your lifestyle, that is having wrong food habits, no exercise, continuing with the stress levels and not taking any measures about it. So with diabetes, again, if I have to explain you the types, there are two types. One is the juvenile diabetes. So this is the diabetes which comes to children, that is kids who get it. And that is the insulin dependent diabetes. So these people have to take insulin. And the second one is the adult onset diabetes, which is the one that we most commonly see. Now, even though they say it's insulin dependent diabetes, in our clinic, we have done a lot of research on kids who have had diabetes that to a pretty high level, 350, 400, and who have been on insulin. And we have treated them just with the naturopathic lifestyle and managing it with the right kind of food and exercise. So most of the people who are on insulin should be able to come back to the medications that is taking tablets and then coming back to a normal lifestyle. Because doctors, allopathy doctors never tell you that you can be out of diabetes. It's actually not their problem because they are not trained on the food part and the exercise part. So they are just trained on what medications will bring down your sugar levels. So how do you do it? Most of the things we are already aware of. But what happens is once we are into the diabetic stage, we are like, okay, I've got the diabetes. Now I have to not eat sweet. We are aware of everything. But what happens is when you look at the sweet, you are more tempted to eat sweet. It is because you are in it's like you are in an ocean, but you don't have water to drink because it's salt water. The same thing is with you. When you are having diabetes, it's like you have sugar all around, but your organs and your muscles are not getting enough sugar. So you want to eat more sugar just because you are starving. So this is what happens when you have diabetes. The reason you have diabetes is because, like I said, your body produces insulin. And this insulin is produced by pancreas, which is in the abdomen. Now, when you put on excess weight, there's fat around the pancreas and also there's fat on your abdomen. So this kind of pushes your organs and it's like suffocating inside. It's not able to produce enough insulin. That is one reason. Another reason is every cell in your body would be fat. There is excess fat in every cell in your body, of your body. So what happens is this excess fat would not let the cell do its normal function. Every cell has its own function. It functions on its own. So when it's trying to do its function because of the excess fat and the toxins that is surrounding it, the receptors which will open up and, you know, take up the insulin and give up the sugar levels are not able to do its function. So here what we do is in naturopathy, we do a cleanse. People who have, the best part to do is you do a cleanse every year, at least for 7 to 10 days. This is one way you could do it. Or so when you do a cleanse, we give you a diet, we give you exercises, yoga, asana, all that. Panchakarma kriyas, all that we do. In case if you are not able to do it or if you cannot do it, then you can do fast once a week. Every week, one day you choose to fast. So during that time, what you do is you either be on water or you be on juices and you make sure you are exercising every day. At least 30 minutes of exercise because your body is just not muscle, bone and all the organs. There are also energy channels that keep running. So when your body is like very stiff, the energy that moves into each and every organ isn't functioning. So there is a time clock within your body as well. So if you don't go to bed early by 10 o'clock, 10 to 12, the energy flows to the liver. And the liver is a detox organ. So that time, if you're not going to bed, the liver is tense and it is not able to detox. So then what happens? The stress on the liver is put onto the other organs. So everything counts. How much you sleep, how much you exercise, what food you eat. So all this is the lifestyle change which you should be adopting. Just taking pills is not going to, it's just going to control your sugar levels for that time being. But eventually this tablet, what you take, it is going to put a load on the liver because it has to again metabolize and be thrown out of the body. And again, it has to be thrown out through your urine by your kidneys. So the kidneys would function and eventually your kidneys would start failing. Then you would also end up with the cardiovascular problem. So one complication leads to another complication. So always, when you are diabetic, you shouldn't be stressing, oh, I have diabetes and do nothing about it. But you just start taking steps, that is exercise more often. Every day you make sure that 6 o'clock to 6:30 you're exercising, you're having ample amount of water, you're doing, in case you're stressed out, you can do yoga sana, you can do meditation. There's so many things. Or if you're more of a prayer person, you can pray to God and let out your stress. You can sing some bhajans, or if you like to dance, if you like to swim, or you have some hobbies, you're connecting to something and you're letting out the stress. So this is something where you can completely detox your mind as well, because when you're stressed, there's so many hormones that are secreted, cortisol, there's glucagon. These are all stress hormones which will contract your tissues and your cells. And then again, your body would not be able to release the insulin and take up the sugar. So that is too much in your blood and you have this diabetes. Right. There are a lot of natural remedies that you can follow and keep your blood sugar at check. So basically what you have to do is you should avoid taking anything that is white. So white sugar, white rice, maida items, all this which is unhealthy, you should kind of reduce it. Also, people who are diabetic, they should reduce on the amount of the curd intake, sugar, milk intake, which is fatty food, and they should literally stop taking cold items like ice cream and also very sweet ice items like chocolate, because this is going to add up on the excess fat which is already there. So that is one thing. If I were to give you the natural remedies, like how Shobha ma'am was talking about the bitterness that causes you to not enjoy life, the same way in your body, bitter is one of the tastes. So you should have, like all emotions, you should be happy, you should be sad, you should be bitter sometimes, you should be angry, because we are all human. Sometimes what we do is we are scared to expose our emotions to people, and we tend to be sweet all the time. So we try to be excessively sweet to people and the bitterness is inside us. So sometimes if you have some kind of bitterness, you can either, you know, put it out in nice ways. But you don't have to, you know, cover yourself all the time, but you can still express in nice ways so people also know you have emotions. Or you can, if you don't like to put out your emotions, you can, like I said, you can do your swimming, jogging, you can pray to God, all these ways you can put out your emotions. Again, with the taste as well, bitter taste, like we have salt, we have sweet, there's spicy, and one of the tastes is bitter. So we need to take bitter as well in our diet. Usually as kids, we don't require much of bitter food. Once in a while, if you take bitter, is sufficient. But as we age, in our middle age and further on, we should be taking a lot of bitter in our food. How do we consume bitter? So when you consume bitter, you shouldn't make it very sweet that the bitterness is not felt. the bitterness should be there and you should feel it. Some of the people take it in the form of tablets, but when you take it in the tablets, the bitterness is not felt from year to year. So there are a lot of receptors in these areas as well. So the best thing to do is you can take bitters in the form of neem. Every day you can chew around 3 to 5 neem leaves. So just keep it in your mouth and slowly start chewing. 1 or 2 days you might feel a little bit difficult, but later on, as you see that, you know, your blood sugar levels are improving and you're feeling much better, then you see this habit is helping you and you kind of like it. So you can go with eating neem leaves, or you can take around 2 to 3 twigs of with the leaves, the neem leaves, and you take 2 glasses of water and put the twigs and boil it for around 3 to 5 minutes. Then the color of the water changes to light green. And when you taste it, it's a little bitter. So you drink it warm. So you can take the neem water. That is one way you can take. Otherwise, you can powder the leaves and you can warm the water and you can have the neem water. This is one good way. Another technique is jamun seed. Jamun seed is excellent remedy for a diabetes. What you do is, whenever you're having jamun, you have to dry the jamun in the sun, wash it properly, powder it and keep it with you. Every day you can have 1/2 spoon of jamun with water or with buttermilk. So this is an excellent remedy to take out the excess, like how we say in Ayurveda, there's vata, pitta, kapha. So kapha is one predominant factor which is going to block your tissue and cells. So when you take the jamun seed powder with water or with buttermilk, this will kind of clean out all the kapha that's in your blood, lymph, and all your tissues. So that's an excellent way to take the jamun powder. Then we also have amla powder. So what you could do is you can take amla powder or amla juice along with turmeric powder. So this, if you take all this what I have mentioned, if you take it with empty stomach, it's a very good remedy, because empty stomach, the cleansing and the healing is more better. So what you do is you can take one amla, you juice it without the seed, then you put around 1/2 spoon of turmeric to this, and then you mix it with water or buttermilk, anything, or with your juices, and you have it every day. So this is one of the excellent remedies for diabetes. There are a lot of remedies, but every day as you keep detoxing your blood, this is a better way to do. Another thing is you have to make sure you exercise every day for 30 minutes, at least 30 minutes. So exercise doesn't mean you simply walking, talking to your friends, it doesn't help. You have to sweat out. So usually for your body to increase your metabolism, it takes around the heat in your body, the metabolic heat, it takes around 10 minutes. So when you keep walking, your body will get heated up and then it will start sweating. That is the time when your body is throwing out the toxins. So you have to exercise 20 to 30 minutes, and during winter, you have to do a little more, because that time your body would need a little more time to let out that heat, because your body is already cooled down. So the diet part, the exercise part. So with the diet, I would also like to mention that you should avoid as much as carbohydrates. Try not to eat anything which gives you immediate rush of sugar. So like if you're having rice, try to switch from white rice to red rice. Basmati rice is good because this rice has low glycemic index. So when you have low glycemic index, the rush of the sugar, as soon as you have food, isn't there. It will be at slow phases. So make sure you're having low glycemic index food, high fiber diet, and you can have protein food, because your body is a little starving. And when you have protein food, your body would metabolize it slowly and it will be released slowly to your system. But not very high protein. When you have protein, you try to balance it according to your body weight. So if you are around 60 kgs, 60 grams of protein is more than sufficient. Don't go for more protein. Some people have 100, 200 grams of protein which becomes excess. When it becomes excess, your body will definitely go to store it. And when it goes for storing, then you, first of all, it gets stored in your liver. And when the liver becomes fatty, the detox becomes very, very slow. So every day as you exercise, the excess fat what you have eaten, consumed, would be washed out in your sweat or through your urine. There's so many ways you can exercise. So this is about the exercise and the food. I can tell you a few asanas that we can do.
No, yes, basically what you're telling is that you're really advising us to have a complete lifestyle change.
Yes.
You know, and when there is a complete lifestyle change, then there is a possibility of the sugar getting into control through natural ways.
You know?
So first mentally we have to be ready that yes, my whole lifestyle needs to be changed. You know,
yeah.
It's not something one or two days or one or two tips. It's like a complete change of habit.
Yeah, so usually people with genetic predisposing factors, like if your parents have, or if you have hypertension, or if you are obese, then you have to make sure you are checking your blood sugar levels at least every 3 months, 6 months. Or if you're having thyroid problems, you have to make sure you check that you have diabetes, your sugar levels. So how do you check it? So there are certain signs where you can check it. You see that your teeth will have excess coating. Like when you wake up in the morning, there's too much coating in your teeth. You feel excessive thirst. You feel you have to drink more water. You go to the toilet more often, especially during the night time to wake to go to the toilet, because the kidneys are not resting since there's too much toxins in your blood. And delayed wound healing. So if you get a wound, you see that, you know, there's itching or there's something taking too much time for it to heal because of the excess sugar in your blood. And also, the best way you could do it is you can have a monitoring apparatus, the sugar check. You can check your blood sugar levels during fasting. And you can check it after food. And the most ideal time is 2 hours after food. You have to make sure you have had the same amount of food as other days. Not like today you have less and check your blood sugar just to feel better. Have the same amount of food like how you have usually, and then check your postprandial blood sugar. That is after you having food. There's also another test which helps you to check the long term, that whether you're getting it in future. So there are a lot of ways you can do it. But for the time being, what I would say is you just check on how much time you're going to the toilet, especially in the night. You should not be going to the toilet. Nothing should wake you up. But in case you're going more than once, then you should be checking your blood sugar. If you see that you're feeling more hungry or you're feeling more thirsty, then you should check your blood sugar. If your wound is not healing, then you should check. This is only the... These are the signs so that you are not overlooking your diabetes and then it is already high. Most of the times patients come when your blood sugar is 400 and 500 and above. And then it becomes very difficult to get it down. So initially, if you know that, okay, now I can take care of yourself. The best way to go is not to put on weight. Every time you know you have a shaving skin and you keep checking your weight and then you know, okay, I have put on weight. Now it's my duty to bring down my weight. How do I do it? How do I, you know, all the things already. So adapt that in your lifestyle. Just don't push it for tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll do it. Just start from today, whether it could be your diet, could be exercise, with whatever it is. Okay. So there are a lot of other techniques you can do, but I don't want to tell you too many of them. I've just given you a dose of what is very much important about the bitter gourd juice, amla and turmeric. Then you can have jamun seed powder. You can have methi soaked in water early in the morning. Make sure you're not having too much sugar in your food. Try to avoid a lot of taking carbohydrates during night. Night times, you try to have more of chapatis and have an early dinner. Go to bed early. So all these things would be an excellent way to control your diabetes. So now we'll move on to the exercise part. So with the exercise, every part of exercise is important when it comes to managing a weight, because your body would need different types of exercise. But I'll give you particular asanas that is required for diabetes, especially because your pancreas are on the side of your body, and usually people with diabetic have a pot belly. Pot belly is in the sense where the mid part of your abdomen has a lot of fat. If you try to hold your tummy and you're feeling that this much fat is in your tummy, that means you are predisposing to get more and more sugar levels in your blood. So how do you control the this excess fat? So then we'll be going for more of the twisting poses. So I'll be showing you the asanas. We don't have much of a time, I guess. We are already.
Yeah, I was just thinking. It's already. We have only 10 minutes left. 12 minutes left. We can just do that. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So we'll go with the asanas. So I'll show you some of the asanas over here. So here you stand in the sthiti position with your hands by the side of your body. Then we'll go to slowly raising your hands to 90 degrees. Turn your palm as you breathe in. Further, breathe in. When your biceps touches your ears, you have to further lift your arm and then bend to your left. This way. Bend to the left. So here you can feel a stretch on the right side of the body. And let your left hand hang loose. Maintain this around 20 seconds. Then inhale and come up. Exhale and slowly bring your hands down. Now we'll do it on the opposite side. So what you do over here is the same thing. Take your left hand up. Turn your palm up. Raise. And bend to the opposite side. Here, you're looking forward, your right hand hanging loose. Now you feel a beautiful stretch on the left side of your body. Again, maintain it for 20 seconds. And exhale. Slowly release. Feel the blood rushing to your fingertips. And relax. Since we don't have much time, I'll move on to the next one. Here, you can separate your legs a little bit. Bring your hands in front of you. Tiryaka Tadasana. So then, you're looking back. Again, you're twisting your back. You can place your right hand on your left shoulder. And your right elbow should be at the level of your shoulder. Feel the twist on your back. Maintain this position. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Slowly inhale, come front, exhale, and down. Now we'll do on the opposite side. Inhale and turn to the opposite side. Feel the stretch, the twist. Maintain 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Inhale and exhale. Take a deep breath in. And breathe out. Very good. Now extend your legs further. Turn your right foot to the right. That is, turn your right foot. Okay, so here you turn your right foot to the right. Inhale, raise your both hands up. Exhale, twist your body and then catch hold of your left toes and your right arm stretched out, and you're looking up at the ceiling. Yeah, there's a beautiful twist to your body. Parivritta Trikonasana. We'll maintain this for 10 more seconds. 3, 4, 5. Normal breathing. Don't hold your breath. Just enjoy this pose. 8, 9, 10. Now inhale. Exhale. Now turn your left foot to the left side. That is, you're turning your left foot this way. Inhale. Exhale and twist. And touch your right toes with your right fingers and gaze at the ceiling. Feel the beautiful twist. Try to keep your knees straight. Keep breathing, normal breathing. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Very good. Inhale, come up. Exhale, bring your hands down and relax in the standing position. Now feel the changes after the twist. We have done 3 of the asanas, both on the right and the left side in the standing position. Feel the changes. Now we'll go on to the sitting position. Okay, so since we don't have much time, we'll go on to the pranayama. I like to finish with the pranayama. Now you can sit in any comfortable position. I like to sit with one of my feet placed on my thighs. So that way you feel the stretch. Okay. So here you make sure your spine is nice and tall, eyes are closed, and go for deep breathing. Inhale, exhale. Now your complete focus on the tip of your nostrils, tip of your nose. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Now once again, when you breathe in, I want you to feel the entire process starting from the tip of your nose. Feel the inside of your nostrils. And feel the cold air entering into your throat and into your lungs. Just feel this entire process. Inhale. Hold it there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now as you exhale, feel the warm air coming out of your nostrils. Once again, breathe in deep. Inhale. Feel the cold air. Hold it there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now exhale slow and deep. Now just observe your face and your body. There's so much change after the deep breath. Now we'll go for Bhastrika Pranayama. So keep your hands by the side of your shoulders. Now inhale and exhale. So inhale deep, exhale quick. So we'll do this 20 times. Inhale. Now close your eyes and feel the relaxation after quick breathing. Feel the skin of your face. Feel the temperature of your palms and soles. Now we'll go for the same practice one more time. Inhale, exhale. Very good. Now relax. Feel total relaxation after a Pasca practice. Now we'll go for a practice of cooling pranayama. So you have to clench your teeth and breathe through the gaps of your teeth. Close your mouth and breathe out through your nose. Once again, breathe in, breathe out. So keep repeating. As you breathe in, feel the cold air entering through your teeth and the cold air pulling up your tongue and your entire throat. And as you breathe out through your nose. So we'll do this again three more times. Inhale. Exhale through your nose. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Now we'll go on to Bhastrika Pranayama. Plug your ears with the index finger. Take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, we'll chant Ma Kara. Inhale. Once again. Just feel the vibrations of Ma Kara, relaxing your head region. Go for palming. When you feel the heat, cup your fingers, place them over your eyes. Relax your face muscles. Take a deep breath in. Look at your fingers and thank you. So I've given you a few tips on how you should manage your blood sugar and